Good afternoon. I've got a nice summer cold. I don't feel very good. And I'm slowly getting organized. I'm in that phase where I'm actually starting to look a little bit better. I'm almost done with my clothes. Then I was going to do art supplies and then bathroom stuff. But I get myself up for like 10 minutes and then I sit back down. And have no energy. But I was texting Rosie yesterday, like, my physical is under the weather, but I can honestly and sincerely say that it's a range of emotion with none excluded, but the kind of core baseline is acceptance and peace and awe and gratitude and resiliency and joy and thanksgiving and calm and rest and curiosity and delight and well-being and ease and appreciation and love. Four guys ghost me this weekend. It happens quite often, actually. I think they want to connect with me, and then we do, and then we might text a little bit, and then they don't ever like invite me out to do anything or make a plan. It's kind of like they're waiting for me to do it. I'm not sure, but I'm not gonna play ball that way. So, I mean, it's not like a bad feeling, it's just, and then I was listening to a recent, YouTube video, and it kind of, not triggered, I'd say, just, touched on a few of, like, programming around, celibacy, and sexuality, and dating, and relationships and love and trauma and that was early this morning. It's early afternoon now. I'll let my mind touch on it, and I'm just curious of like why it's brought up, like feelings, not necessarily shame or guilt, I'm not that far, but just uncomfortable, like maybe a little bit of doubt in my own path and my own journey, and like, yeah, it's like this is what I'm doing wrong. Am I being reckless? Am I being selfish? Am I being, you know, promiscuous? Am I a loose? Am I being a loose woman? And I guess technically, yes. So then it's just a fun cycle in my head, because then I get to this side and then I just laugh because I'm like, well, it's kind of true and you don't know what you're doing and maybe that's right and I don't know. What am I going to post this to? I don't have internet right now, and so it seems to post pretty easy onto YouTube, but when I try to post things onto OnlyFans, it just is forever and then it cancels out and starts over. So that's okay. I'm going to have to kind of get used to the idea of the whole OnlyFans. It's a little in my head. There's still some more work to be done as far as really centering in my reason and my intention behind it and being comfortable with it. So kind of just walking that line, exploring both sides. And I don't know why did I start recording? I guess just to share my journey right now. But yeah, the failed attempts at connecting. Now I'm like, I'm sick today and I'm trying to get organized and now actually I have plans with the girls for the next couple nights before I start heading up north. But so actually I'm like, oh, maybe I just wasn't aware that I was needing a break, and so the universe took over for me. And so I do know that that's kind of normal. Like, it goes in spurts, and it's easier out of town because it's already, like, especially that far away in Europe, like, it's just understood that, like, there's not going to be an ongoing, like, full-time relationship. Like, our lives are so far apart and so different. It's not like we can see each other on the weekends or, you know, whatever. But I don't know how this goes. Never been here before. Never done it. And that was one of the reasons I was thinking, like, what came to me now, you know, was like, as I've been sitting with the uncomfortableness of it, it's like, well, your journey's so different. You were a virgin when you got married. You didn't really even have possession, full sovereignty over your own body, sexuality, even mind, even spirituality and heart. And I'm not saying it's bad. I don't regret it because it's what it's led to. It's been beautiful. But what is my point? My brain is foggy. What is my point? Oh, that because of my journey, you know, and then being married until just recently, I have hardly any understanding, knowledge, intimacy with myself. And how am I going to feel secure and confident and not just repeat choosing somebody that I think that will, like, put up with me or settle? It's hard to put into words if I don't know me and I don't really, and how am I not going to have true boundaries and know what I want and don't want and what works for me and what doesn't unless I start doing some research. So I think too, we're coming into an age where it's like customization. We have to trust each buddy, everybody's path. You know, you can't, it's just like, you know, if you just quit drinking, don't move, don't make any major changes, don't date for a year. And I can see why that's most of the time good, but also sometimes that's just white knuckling it, and you're at a stage where you need to start learning how to live and be sober. I don't know why I jumped to sobriety, but I don't know. I probably shouldn't be recording because it's not super clear, but yeah, I don't care. Like, who, what standard am I trying to meet? The reason I started recording ultimately is I knew it would motivate me. It would give me a little burst of energy to get up and keep going, because this is giving my life a lot of meaning right now. This is allowing me to channel it into a creative use and follow what feels true to my life path. And I'm an Aries. I'm the first of the zodiac with a Sagittarius North Node and Gemini Rising. I want to communicate, I want to share, and I want to explore. I don't want to do the norm. I am actually built to explore new things, new ideas, new ways of living, new concepts, new paradigms, and not just hear about them and have somebody tell you about them, but to experience them for myself, to have inner knowing, direct spiritual experience. Well, it's all spiritual to me now, not in a religious way, in a very personal way, but that includes my body. That's what was missing. Big part of what was missing was my body, and my, like, heart and my emotions, and being raised thinking that I was too emotional, and the whole Adam and Eve story that I'm not to be trusted, and that, you know, like, what if it's backwards? What if Eve eating the fruit saved us all? There's so many ways to look at it. But I know I would not be attractive to the kind of man that I feel attracted to if I didn't go through this process of knowing myself more intimately and learning to love and be intimate with others. And I go in spurts too. I go through periods of where I'm intentionally kind of putting the direct sexual and relational, you know, ships on the back burner. But I don't have a hard, fast line, like, this is when, this is not. So if we're waiting till we're ready, we're waiting for someone to tell us we're ready. Who's going to tell us we're ready? Are we waiting for ourselves to feel ready? I don't know. I don't know that day is ever going to come. But so I think it's going to have to be this customized, intuitive, feeling into it, testing of the waters. And if you trust yourself, if you're healing, And you, part of that healing is learning to know yourself and trust yourself. If you trust yourself, you don't have to be so worried about the others' motives and stuff, because if you trust yourself, your intuition will tell you when it's time. And if your intuition's telling you move forward, but you use your mind and the past to decide to stop. So I think it's just, for me, it's like, just like anything, like if there was ever to be a marriage, it would be a living marriage to myself. How am I today? What's true for me today? What do I know? What am I avoiding? Do I still want this life? Do I want these people? Do I want this relationship with myself? Do I want this relationship with others? If I do, is there something that I can change to make it better without being unsatisfied or negative or critical or starting to unappreciate all the positive? I don't know. Yeah, it's a fine line. There's no, it's you're walking right along the edge. You don't get to just camp out on one side or the other, because either way it leads to stagnation or trauma. Disconnect from oneself. Sin, being turned away from God, which is to me is spirituality or your true self. Being disconnected from that, turned away from it. Repent is to turn back. It's all just turn back. Come back to yourself. Come back to your highest self. Come back to truth, to love, to the all, to the one. Okay. Love you.